we've come a long way, isn't it, in terms of political tolerance?
Yeah, absolutely true. If you look at the period between 1993 and 1994, especially in places like KwaZulu-Natal, where the number of lives that were lost as a result of a misunderstanding said to be between the ANC and the IFP. And then what we saw happening immediately after the 1994 elections was that there was a certain degree of intolerance that was happening as a result of the elections, because there were people who felt that justice was not done during the elections, and therefore they felt aggrieved. And we saw an escalation of even more violence after the elections. But since then, we've seen a drastic change whereby people are getting more mature politically and therefore being tolerant of the other political parties.
But how did those political divisions affect people in the region?
Political divisions had a serious impact, firstly on families, individual families, because we'd find that members of the same family would be belonging to different political formations. Then that would cause some differences amongst family members. But then also even in communities, you would find that in certain communities, there are people who used to live side by side and nicely, but then immediately after the elections, they therefore started now breaking apart, simply because some felt that they were not getting the expecting and therefore started blaming the opposition, those who were on the opposition side. So basically, immediately after the elections, we saw a number of people having what was referred to as revenge attacks, because before the elections, there were people who lost their family members and their friends. So after the elections, then they wanted to fight back. And then as a result of this revenge attacks, so we saw even more bloodshed, especially in KwaZulu-Natal, although the same problem happened elsewhere in the country.
So 20 years later, what cements those warring communities?
I think as a country, we've come of age. It's quite impressive to see that before 1994, we had a number of places that were said to be no-go areas, where a particular political party was not allowed to come and converse for the electorate. But then subsequent to that, we've seen more tolerance, political tolerance taking place. Say, for instance, if you look at places like Nongoma, which was known to be the strongholds of political parties like the IFP, we've seen even the new political parties like the NFP and the old political parties represented by the ANC conversing freely in places like Nongoma. So I would say as a country, we've come of age to the extent that political tolerance is much better now compared to what it was before 1994.
But Dr. Mgomazulu, what's your take then on the Kwamashu hostels, for instance? We've seen some killings there, a lot of political tension, a lot of tension in fact. What's your take on that area?
Yeah, the Kwamashu incident, it's quite interesting, because the danger that we run into would be to look at that issue strictly from what I would call inter-political point of view, when in fact it's more complex than that. In the first instance, we have intra-political differences amongst members of the same political party. Remember that when political parties compile a list, either a provincial list or a national assembly list, so basically there are people who want to be on top of the list, but then they can't for one reason or the other. Therefore, they would go to an extent of killing their fellow party members simply because they are vying for the position. So this is what I would call intra-party violence. Then once the dealt with, you will then have inter-party violence, whereby you have members of one political party basically fighting the opposition simply because they want to be a ward councillor or they want to be mayors and all of that. So basically the Kwamashu incident is quite more complex. Also because you have people who have political differences from their rural areas. Remember that not everybody was born in Durban. Not everybody was born in Kwamashu hostel, but they come from rural areas. So when they come to these urban centers, they come with this political baggage, some of which has nothing to do with the political affiliation. And the third element, obviously, will be just a peer thuggery. So we have thugs who are killing people, and then we generally assume it's because of political violence. Yeah. So it's more complex than that.
We'll be indeed keeping a close eye on that area, as well as the other 4,700 voting stations across the province. Dr. Becky Mgomazulu, thank you very much indeed for your time. He will be with us throughout the next couple of days. is analyzing the results that are coming through. I think we're expecting the results in KwaZulu-Natal to come through around 1 o'clock a.m. on Thursday morning. So we'll bring you that live right here in KwaZulu-Natal. Political analyst Dr. Bekki Mgomzulu. Indeed, the demon of political intolerance and mindless violence hunted this province for many years, but many agree that the province has since turned the corner. Our special election broadcast continues from KZN. For now, it's back to the capital.